Good evening.
Okay, so within 2-3 minutes, your class will start. Okay, and today we will discuss the AC waveform and its RMS value, right? How to calculate the RMS value of any kind of waveform that is alternating in nature, right? So let your friends join here. Then after 3 or 4 minutes, that means almost 6-5, your class will start. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Okay, so it's almost 6-5. So let's start the RMS value. Let's start from RMS value. Okay, so I hope the screen is visible, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So yesterday's class, this calculation I showed you, okay, that is why we need the calculation of RMS value. Okay, and this is the equation using which you can calculate the RMS value of any kind of simple waveform or composite waveform that's in alternating nature. Okay, just a minute. ঠিক আছে হ্যাঁ আচ্ছা বেশ 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 ঠিক আছে পাঠিয়ে দিচ্ছি আপনাকে হুম 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 ঠিক আছে হ্যাঁ আচ্ছা ঠিক আছে হ্যাঁ ঠিক হ্যাঁ হুম ঠিক আছে আমি ক্লাস নিয়ে নিই তারপর দেখছি ঠিক আছে ওকে সো দিস ইজ দ্য ইকুয়েশন ইউজিং হুইচ ইউ ক্যান ক্যালকুলেট দ্য আর এম এস ভ্যালু অফ এনি কাইন্ড অফ ওয়েভফর্ম অর এনি কাইন্ড অফ সিগনাল রাইট নাও থ্রি ফ্যাক্টর্স ইউ হ্যাভ টু রিমেম্বার দোজ আর ভেরি important factors which describes the propagation of the waveform, or you can say it describes the fundamental property of the waveform or any kind of signal, right? So these are peak factor, form factor, and crest factor. Okay, these three factors are very important. First one is the peak factor. It is the ratio of the maximum value to the RMS value. Okay, just take the example of this waveform. Okay, this sinusoidal waveform. What is the peak value you can observe? It is 1, right? The peak value is 1, this waveform. Whether it is voltage or current, we don't need to know right now. It may be current, it may be voltage, it may be power waveform, any kind of waveform, right? So here the maximum value is 1, as you can see here. Okay, so I am writing here 1. And what is the RMS value? If you calculate the RMS value of the sinusoidal waveform, you will get the RMS value is 1 by root 2. That means 0.707. That is the RMS value. You can see it is already written here. Okay. Now, if you use this formula, you will get the RMS value of the waveform. I will show you with example. Okay, no need to worry. So, the RMS value you can see here is 0.707 of the maximum value. That means we can say here that this is 0.707, or you can write this is 1 by root 2. Okay, so this is your peak factor value. So it is greater than 1, right? That value is actually root 2. That means your answer is 1.414. So this is your peak factor for the sinusoidal waveform. Okay. So this is the peak factor of the sinusoidal waveform. Correct. Now, next one is the form factor. What is the form factor? It is the ratio of RMS value to the average value. Okay. So if you are taking this basic sinusoidal waveform, what is the RMS value? You can see here, this is the RMS value, that is nothing less 1 by root 2 or 0.707 into maximum value. The maximum value is 1, correct? So maximum value is 1 divided by average value. So what is your average value? You have to calculate this. Okay. So you have to calculate the average value of this waveform. Okay. Now the average value will be, here it is written as 0.637 into 1. Okay. So whatever value you are getting from here, that is your form factor. Okay. Next one is called the crest factor. It is the ratio of peak value. It is the ratio of the peak value to RMS value. So that is simple, 1.414, that is root 2. Okay, because inverse of 0.707 is root 2. Okay, that is 1.414. Okay, so that is your crest factor. Correct? And the form factor for a pure sinusoidal waveform always equals to 1.11. This value is given in exam in MCQ type question. Okay, that what is the form factor of a pure sinusoidal waveform? That is 1.11. And crest factor, and the previous one was peak factor, that is root 2. Okay, so you have to remember these values. Otherwise, it will take time to calculate these values, right? So these two values you have to remember. Now, next one is, a voltage waveform is represented by the following equation. Now, based on the previous topic, these numericals you need to solve. Okay, these are the basic numericals. First, V equals to 200 sine omega t. Okay, this is your omega, right? That is 314 t. Now you have to find out the maximum value of the voltage, RMS value of the voltage, average value, frequency, time period, and instantaneous value after 0.05 second. Okay, this question was given in previous year of almost as I remember of 6 marks or 8 marks. Okay, I cannot remember clearly. That was either 6 mark or of 8 marks, right? So what is the maximum value? Now if you remember, we created one equation to describe that waveform. At equals to A max sine 2 pi ft. Okay, that is the basic equation of any sinusoidal waveform, and this 2 pi f is called the angular frequency, that is omega. Okay, that is not w, that is omega, right? Now next, from here we need to calculate the first maximum value. So if you equate these two, you will see that your maximum value is 200. Okay, so your maximum value is 200. So first value, first answer you are getting as 200 volt, that is V max. Okay, acha. And one more thing, in some book you will see that the maximum value is noted by Vm. Okay, in some book it is written as V max. Okay, don't get confused. These two terms you have to check that what they are trying to understand. Okay, what they are trying to say, you have to see that very carefully.
Sir, yes? Sir, maximum value is 200, sir, how?
See, here 80 equals to mx, this equation, there is no problem, I think.
No, sir.
Okay, so if you equate these two equations, that is 80 with V, then this is your normal voltage signal. And if you equate, this sine part will equate with the sine part, and the rest 200.
Okay, sir.
Equates with Mx, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so this Vm is 200 volt here. Okay, and then we calculate the RMS value. For one pure sinusoidal wave, the RMS value, I will show you how it is generating. For a pure sinusoidal wave, this RMS value is always the maximum value divided by root 2. Always, you need to remember this. Okay, I will show you how you are getting this. Right, so this is actually V max divided by root 2. So 200 divided by root 2, so ultimately it is 141.4 volt, that is your RMS value. Okay, and average value is 0.637 into Vm, that is 127.4 volt. Now here also, if you are trying to calculate the form factor, you will get that it is just like the previous theoretical part, value is 1.11. Okay, now if you want to try, do the division, because what is the form factor? It is the ratio of RMS value to the average value. Now do the division, 141.4 divided by 127.4. If you do, it will give you almost 1.11. Okay, you can try. Okay, now see next, what we are going to calculate the frequency. Now look, this 2 pi ft, that is omega t. Okay, now if you equate this internal part, you will see that 314, that is equal to 2 pi f. So I am writing here 2 pi f equals to 314. Here the frequency is unknown. Okay, now f will become 314 divided by 2 pi. Okay, and if you can remember what is the pi value, pi value is 3.14, that is 22 by 7 is called pi. Okay, very important rational number. So that pi value is 3.14. So ultimately you will get 100 by 2. So it will give you 50 hertz. Okay, so this 50 hertz is your frequency. Now how to calculate the time period? Simple inverse. Okay, so do the inverse and its value will be 20 millisecond. Isn't it?
Sir, what is 1.11 value?
1.11, this value. Are you asking this 1.11?
Yes, sir.
This is the form factor. Okay, this is the form factor that I told you earlier. This is the form factor. Okay, this one, form factor. That is the ratio of RMS value to average value. Okay, and for a pure sinusoidal waveform, whether it is current or voltage waveform, the value will be always same. Okay, until unless the waveform is a composite one, then it will differ. Okay, then it will differ. But for a pure sinusoidal like this kind of waveform, you will get 1.11 every time, whatever be its magnitude. Because see, the magnitude always gets cancelled. Right, so it is depending on this value, 0.707 and 0.637, its ratio. So the value is 1.11. Okay, next is instantaneous value after 0.05 second. So what is your instantaneous value? Instantaneous value means you have to give the time here. Okay, what is the time? It is noted here, look, 0.05 second. Okay, so you have to give this 0.05 second as input in this system. Okay, then you will get this 54.12 volt. Okay, what is the meaning of this instantaneous value? Okay, if this question is asked to you in interview, that what is the instantaneous value, then you have to give explanation right like this. Okay, suppose this is your sinusoidal waveform. Okay, and from time to time its voltage changes from positive point, from positive side to negative side. Okay, then it again reaches to zero, then again it goes to positive side. So this is the instantaneous value. At each time, whatever value you are getting, that is your instantaneous value. Okay, just like your instantaneous velocity you learned from your 11 and 12 physics. Okay, this is your instantaneous value. That means for a particular time, how much is your current or how much is your voltage magnitude? That is your instantaneous value. Okay, so just like that, V equals to 200 into sine 314 into T. That is your equation, sine omega T. So omega value you already know, that is 314, okay, radian per second, and this time multiplied. So ultimately you will get this 54.12 volt. Okay, clear? Up to this, is there any query?
No, sir.
Okay, very good. Now we are going to calculate the RMS value and average value from this periodic waveform. Now, how to know that what is your time period? Just look when the waveform repeats the first waveform, that you have to check. Okay, that I want to mean, see here, this is one waveform. Okay, after 100 second it repeats itself. Okay, if you want, so here 100 is your 100 millisecond is your time period. Clear? Now if you look at this sinusoidal waveform, this sinusoidal waveform, this curve repeats itself after this time, because again this waveform you are getting. Okay, so this waveform repeats again after this time. So this is your time period. Okay, you have to understand this one. And already you have an idea, because yesterday's class already I told you, right? Do you remember that? How to know what is your time period?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, very good. So here, what is your time period for this triangular waveform? In this triangular waveform, your 100 millisecond. Okay, so from here, look, what is asked? You have to calculate the frequency. And you already know that frequency is the inverse of the time period. So it is 10 hertz as per your calculation. Okay. Now we have to generate the equation, because look, the average value you have to calculate. And since it is a continuous waveform, no discontinuity is there. That's why you have to generate the VT. Okay. What is your VT for the time period? You have to write like this for your own understanding. Okay. Because at first you need to understand yourself. Then you are going to teach another person or your friend. Okay. So you have to calculate this one. So there is only one straight line, this one. Okay. Okay. Let me erase this first. Okay, so first you have to calculate what is the equation of this straight line. Okay. Now, what are the points? This is a straight line passing through the zero point. Okay, so simply y equals to mx plus c, using that equation you can generate. Okay. Or this point is 0 comma 0, okay, and this point, this maximum point is 100 millisecond comma 10. Okay, so now tell me what is the equation of VT. Calculate it now. You have your copy. Okay.
10x minus 10 by minus 1000 equal to 0.
Okay, give me the final answer. Okay.
Then say minus y minus 100 equal to
0. Minus?
Y.
Okay, that means you are telling with respect to y. Okay, y equals to what?
So y minus y was no. Then y1 I take 0.
Yes.
Y minus y1, y2 minus y1, 10 minus 0.
Y minus y1, okay, fine. So then y1 minus y2 equals to x minus x1 divided by x1 minus x2. This equation you are following, okay. So what is your y? This y is actually your voltage. So no need to write now. Why? What is your y1? You can see here, 0. Then 0 minus 10. Okay. X is your time. X minus x1. What is your x1? That is again 0 divided by 0 minus x2. So what is your x2? That is 100. Okay. So ultimately you are getting y equals to 10 by 100 into x, isn't it? 10 by 100 into x. That means 0.1 into x. And what is your x? That is your time in millisecond. Okay. So 0.1 t. Is this value you are getting?
Yes, sir, at last.
Yes, sir.
Okay,
yes,
fine.
Sir.
Yes, sir. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Now look, without using this calculation, if you have two sets of coordinates, okay, here you have the two sets of coordinates, then you can calculate like this, okay? But if you want to save your time, you have to look in another approach, like y equals to mx. Y equals to mx. This is the straight line equation when it passes through the 0, 0 point. Do you remember this?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
M is nothing but your slope, right? So what is, how to calculate this slope? That is y by x. So 10 divided by 100 into what is your x? T. So in one step, you are getting your equation 0.1 t. Is that right?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this process, you have to look the waveform, right? So you have to look the waveform carefully, that which process you have to use. See, this is the universal one. This process is universal process. But it will take some time. But this one, this process, it will take less time. Okay, so what is your y? Y is nothing but your voltage Vt. Okay, so I can write 0.1 into t when t runs from 0 to 100 millisecond. Okay, now what to do? Next, we are going to calculate the average value and RMS value. Correct? So look here. Here it is done in second. Okay, this here 10 to the power minus 3 is written here. That means they are calculating it in second. So it's up to you which calculation you want to do, whether to do in terms of second or whether to do in terms of millisecond. It's up to you. Right? So first you have to calculate the average value. So use the average value equation. That means 0.1 t dt, okay, integration 1 by capital T. What is your total time period? Your total time period is 100 millisecond. Okay, total time period is 100 millisecond for this waveform, and it runs from 0 to T. That means 0 to 100 millisecond. Okay, now this value will give you 0.1 into t square by 2, correct? So the value you are getting is 1 by t, okay? Look very carefully, this average value you are calculating. This is your V average value, okay? So this value will give you 1 by t, capital T, 0.1 I am keeping outside, okay? Then small t square, by 2, and it will run from 0 to 100, okay? So what is your 1 by capital T? That is again 100 millisecond, right? So I can write here 1 by 100, okay, then it is 0.1 into t square, that means 100 square, okay, so 100 will cancel out, then you will get 10 divided by 2, so ultimately 5. Okay. Is that clear to everyone? The calculation of average value?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, RMS value you need to calculate right now.
So how to calculate? See, here they are considering, here two types of calculation I am showing you. The first calculation, I converted all the equations into second. Okay. But here what I did just right now, that is in millisecond. Because see, I am writing here 100 millisecond. Okay. So you can understand that whatever process you are following, if you keep your units same, you will get the same output. Okay, if you are calculating in second, so all calculations should be done in second unit, right? And if you are doing in millisecond, you will get the same value. Okay, next one is the RMS value. So what is the difference in RMS value? You have to square this term, okay? Okay, let me erase this average value. Okay, this will be same. I need to remove this. Then this portion. Okay, next. Okay, so now we are going to calculate the RMS value. So what is written in the equation? This is our 1 by capital T, right? Then root under. So this is your RMS value. Okay, this is your RMS value. Okay, the upper one will be one small t. Okay, so this value will be your small t, or you can say the small t will be capital T. That means the upper limit of the total time period. So here 1 by t, right? This t will be 100 millisecond. Okay, so better to write here in place of t, better to write 100 because I am calculating in millisecond. Okay, so 1 by t integration 0.01 into t square dt. Okay, so this is your 0 to 100 and then the square root. Okay, so how much value you are getting? 1 by t, there is nothing but 1 by 100, 0.01. What is the integration of t square dt?
T cube by 3.
That means t cube by 3. I am writing here 0 to 100. Okay, then under root. So I am writing it here. The same value you are getting every time. Okay. So here it will be 0.01 because 1t means this is your 100 into 100 cube by 3. Okay. So 100 will cancel out. Here it will be 2. Then 1 root. Okay. So I can write this one as 0.1 into 100 divided by root 3. So how much value you are getting? 10 divided by root 3. Okay. So similarly, look here in this equation. How much value you are getting? 10 to the power minus 3. So this value will be cancelled out with 3 zeros. Okay. So ultimately here also you are getting 10 by root 3. So that value is 5.78. Okay. Is the calculation clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then calculate the form factor. you will get different value if you calculate. Okay, so for pure sinusoidal waveform, the form factor will be only 1.11. Now, if it is asked for different waveform, you need to calculate the form factor, it will be different, and you have to calculate it, right? Okay, now this is your homework today. Okay, if you can calculate this, send a snapshot. Okay, and now we are going to solve for another type of waveform to can calculate its the average value and the RMS value. Okay, let's do that. Okay, everyone take the snapshot of this figure. Okay, you have to send this. If you can solve this one, send me the snapshot in the group. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Okay, now I stop the screen sharing here. Where was that? Okay, just a minute. Okay, is the screen visible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now, we are going to calculate the RMS value for one composite waveform. Okay, RMS value and average value. So, here, so this is one kind of composite waveform that you are seeing here. Okay, this value is 10. This value is 5. Now he's calling. Okay, just a minute. Hello? Bol. Besh, thik ache. This is your 30. Okay, just a minute. It's wrong here. Okay, so you, as you can see here, it is one type of composite waveform. Okay, you can see here. Okay, this is the time is in second. This is in second. Okay, and this one is one voltage waveform, right? So, what you have to find out, its RMS value, okay, and then the average value, and then the form factor. Okay, so first we are going to calculate the average value. That means we need to, okay, first of all, tell me what is the time period here, what is the value of capital T?
30 seconds.
Okay, so now 30 seconds that you are getting as time period. Okay, now you have to calculate the VT for 3 time division. Look here, that this is the first wave. Okay, with this is your first wave. With this, another square wave is added, right? So total 3 sets of time you are getting, 0 to t, 100, then 10 t, 20, then 20, t, 30. Okay, so when 0 to 10, what will be your first waveform? Tell me. When the time is in between 0 to 10, what is your equation?
Sir, y is equals to x.
That means it will be simple 10.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, for first case, for 0 to 10 second, this value will be 10. But it is not depending on t. Look. Okay. Because this is constant value. Next. When t is in between 10 to 20, the value is 5. When it is 20 to 30, the value is 0. Okay? So now it's become very easy to find the average value, because as per our calculation, the average value equation is 1 by t. 0 to t vt dt. Okay, so now I can write here 1 by 30. Okay, here I am giving one third bracket, because what is capital T? That is up to 30. So I am dividing in three set. 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30. But remember, for 20 to 30 seconds, your magnitude is 0. So no need to write, because whatever you want to multiply, the ultimate value you are getting is purely 0. Okay, so 0 to 10. And what is the magnitude here? That is 10 into dt, right? Plus 10 to 20, that is 5 into dt. Okay, bracket close, because we don't need the last part, that is 20 to 30, because its magnitude is already 0. Now, if there is any magnitude like this, okay, if there is any magnitude like 2 or 3, then you have to write. Okay, so I am erasing this one. Now, calculate this value and tell me what value you are getting. Okay, what is your average value? Tell me.
Five.
Then do it very fast. That is 10 into 10. Okay, within third bracket, it will be 5 into 10. So 10, 100, 150, 5 volt. Very good. So 5 volt you are getting as average voltage. Now you have to calculate the RMS voltage. Okay. So calculate it first. What is the RMS voltage value? That is 1 by T integration V T square into dt. Okay. Now, 1 by 30. What will be your equation? That is 10 square into dt. So I am writing down directly 0 to 10, that is 100 dt, okay, plus 10 to 20, it is 25 dt, okay. Now, next one. How much value you are getting? Have you solved? Solve it fast, because only multiplication you have to do very carefully. That's all. That is 25 into 10. Okay, and after all, you have to do the square root. Do not forget it, because after calculation, after at the end of calculation, many students just forgot to do that square root part. Okay, do not ever forget that. So it is your 1000 and 1000, and here is 250. So 125/3 is the value you are getting.
Yes, sir.
I can say that 5 root under of 5/3 volt. Okay. Now, calculate the form factor. Form factor. This value will be average value divided by RMS value, or RMS by average. Which one?
The RMS value by average value.
Good. So it is RMS value by average value. So this 5 will be cancelled out, right? So whatever value you are getting, that is root under of 5/3. Now you have calculator in your hand. Now tell me what value it is in decimal point. Tell me what is root under of 5/3.
0.74.
Yes, sir.
0.74. Okay. So this is the form factor you are getting for this type of composite waveform. Okay. So I have shown you several kinds of waveform, and one waveform already I have given as for your study purpose. Okay. Now, some types of waveforms are there. Okay. Where this type of figure you will get. Okay, this kind of waveform. Then again, some gap. Then again, okay, this kind of waveform you will see in some book. So at that time, what you have to do? You have to configure two equations for this time to this time first. Okay, this is just y equals to constant part, whatever value you have here. Okay, and then one straight line equation. Look, one straight line equation you have to create. So two points you have. Okay, so then y minus y1 divided by y1 minus y2, using that universal equation, you can generate the straight line equation. Okay, then this use that RMS value and average value equations, you will get the answer. Okay. Is that clear to everyone that how to generate this kind of value?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
So now if, now, okay, just a minute. Now, if this kind of numerical is given, suppose if this sinusoidal waveform is given, then what you have to do? If sinusoidal waveform is given, similar case, V average. Okay, suppose it is a voltage waveform, its maximum value is V max. Okay, I am writing here V max. And what to write here? It is sinusoidal waveform. So instead of 2 pi f, I am writing here omega t. Okay. Now this x-axis is t. So v average value. This one we have need to write. Okay. And this will be 0 to time period. Okay, and 1/time period. Clear? Now, look how it is done. Because RMS value I told you, and you can easily calculate from this calculation also. So average value I am showing only, RMS value, it's your work to calculate. It is very easy, no need to worry.
Okay, now what is your sine omega t? That is your sine omega t from 0 to t. Now V max by t, what is sine integration of sine omega t? That is cos omega t
minus cos omega.
Right, so cos, okay, 1 dt will be there, don't forget that 1 dt will be there. Okay, I just forgot that cos omega t, okay, divided by omega with minus sign. Now instead of that minus sign, I am changing the limits. Is that okay?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Next, V max divided by total time period equals to cos of omega t. Now, what is cos zero value? That is
one.
One, sir.
That is 1 minus, what is this? Cos omega capital T. Okay, that is cos omega capital T. And here, I am writing here omega into capital T. Okay, now, if you can remember, what is frequency? That is 1 by capital T, isn't it? So I can write ft equals to 1. Okay, this one is very important part here in this calculation. So ft equals to 1. Okay, now look, what is your v max here? V max divided by what is omega? That is 2 pi f into t. 2 pi f into t. Here also 1 minus cos of 2 pi. What is your f value? Okay, f value you need not to worry. Okay, what is your ft? That is also 1. Right? So, v max divided by 2 pi into 1 minus cos 2 pi. So what is the value of cos 2 pi? That means cos 360, that is cos 0, that is again 1. So 1 minus 1, 0. So ultimately, your answer for V average, if you are taking for full time period, you will get zero value. Now, can you explain this? Why are we getting zero value? Because in our calculation, nothing we did wrong. Okay, think about this one. We will discuss that in next class. Okay, why average value we are getting as zero for sinusoidal waveform, but RMS value, if you calculate the RMS value, you will get one definite answer, that is V max divided by root 2. You will get one definite answer. Check this one at home. Okay, you will get one definite answer. But why in case of average value you are getting this big zero? That is a very important question. Okay, now you have to find why this value is zero. Yes. Okay, so we will discuss that in next class. So your today's class is up to this. And the module 1's that representation of the waveform is completed. Okay, in next class, that what will happen if resistor, inductor and capacitor is included in AC circuit, what will happen? That we will discuss step by step. Okay, so I stopped the screen sharing. Now you have to what to find, and you have almost up to 1st January, if I clearly remember, isn't it?
Sir, I have a question. Sir, you showed us in the graph of sine, sinusoidal
yes.
form.
Yes.
If the graph is in the form of tan, then how could we do that?
Calculate that and tell me what value you are getting. Same process you have to follow.
Instead of sine, we have to get tan.
Yes, instead of sine, if you use tan, what is your total time period from 0 to infinite? Right, because tan 0 is 0 and tan 90 means you are getting infinite. Okay, so at that time, the curve gets discontinued. Isn't
yes,
it?
Sir. Yes.
Okay, just a minute. All of you give your attendance in the chat box while I am discussing this answer. Okay. So if we use that tan, then what is your equation? Suppose Vm into tan theta, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So when you are doing Vm into tan theta, then Vm or tan omega t, Vm into tan omega t into dt. So after integration of tan, what value you will get? Integration of tan theta is? What is the integration of tan theta? That you have to find first and use the limit. Okay, what is the limit? Limit is from 0 to capital T. And remember, the tan 90 is always infinite. So there you are getting some discontinuity. So for discontinuous waveform, if you are going to calculate this average value, you won't get any finite answer.
Yes, sir.
Are you getting my point? Okay, try this app. Try yourself. Okay, you will find your own answer. Try that.
Can't we do the process of sine x by cos x is equals to tan x?
Yes, you can do.
By merging two graphs, sine x and cos x?
No, that calculation, what you want to do, that is your tan theta, integration of tan theta d theta. Okay, so yes, you can, whatever value you are getting, put the limits. Check what value you are getting here.
Yes, sir.
Okay, okay. Before asking me that question, do yourself whatever value you are getting. And if you are not satisfied with your own process, then send me the snapshot. I will tell. Okay. Is that right, Amit?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine.
Sir?
Yes?
Sir, for the sinusoidal wave, sir, how can we find the Vt, sir?
What? Vp?
Yes, sir. Means for any time given, sir, how can we find the expression of, sir, Vt as we find in the earlier cases, sir?
Yes, if you have the, normally what we want to write, what we express as, if you are asking about the sinusoidal waveform, we write Vm into sine omega t. That is the universal representation of sinusoidal waveform.
Yes, sir.
Okay, if you are asking about cosine waveform, then what is your universal equation? Vm cos omega t.
Okay.
Then you need to find that what is your total time period, what is your limit, upper limit and lower limit. You have to find then.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay, any query till now? Okay, fine.
So all of you give your attendance in the chat box, and I have already updated the module 1 in classroom. Okay. So everyone go there and check the study materials, right? Okay, thank you everyone. If you have given attendance, you may leave the meeting. Your class is over.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.